The most high-yield pathology that is related to hexose monophosphate shunt is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. Glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency is an X-linked recessive disorder. Recall that glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase is the major enzyme in oxidative phase of hexose monophosphate shunt. Glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase basically oxidizes glucose-6-phosphate in the cytosol to 6-phosphogluconate, and by this glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase traps glucose for hexose monophosphate shunt. Moreover, oxidative phase, also called irreversible phase, because oxidative reactions can occur only in one direction. This means that NADPH molecules cannot be produced from ribulose-5-phosphate, so the only possibility to produce NADPH is by oxidation of glucose-6-phosphate. And this irreversible feature makes glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase the only enzyme that can trap glucose-6-phosphate for hexose monophosphate shunt. With glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, there is no enzyme to take glucose into hexose monophosphate shunt. So organism cannot produce sufficient amount of NADPH molecules, and this results in two major features of glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. The first one is hemolytic anemia with jaundice. To explain this, recall that NADPH are the essential elements for recycling of glutathione. NADPH molecules are produced by oxidative phase of hexose monophosphate shunt, and the key enzyme in oxidative phase is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So with glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, generation of NADPH molecules decrease. This causes decrease in activity of glutathione reductase. Decrease in glutathione reductase causes decrease in recycling of glutathione. Thereby the amount of glutathione decrease, and this results in decrease in activity of glutathione peroxidase. With decrease in activity of glutathione peroxidase, the detoxification of hydrogen peroxide decreases. As a result, hydrogen peroxide progressively accumulates inside the cell. And the higher the amount of hydrogen peroxide molecules, the more severe oxidative damage they cause. And basically, the amount of hydrogen peroxide molecules is determined by the hydrogen peroxide formation and hydrogen peroxide detoxification. As we see, hydrogen peroxide detoxification in case of glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency is impaired, and exactly this creates peroxidative state. But peroxidative state can be also aggravated by the increase in hydrogen peroxide production. And we have several factors that can provoke oxidative stress by increase in hydrogen peroxide formation. The most well-known agents are favobins, infections as pneumonia or viral hepatitis, and drugs as primaquine and sulfur drugs. The concept is that they all induce oxidative stress that cause increase in generation of reactive oxygen species. Initially it's superoxide, and then superoxide can be converted into hydrogen peroxide. So this leads to a massive production of hydrogen peroxide that overwhelms already limited glutathione detoxification capacity. As a result, massive amount of hydrogen peroxide accumulates inside the cell and causes severe oxidative damage to the cell. So glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency creates severe peroxidative state in all tissues. But we have cells that are the most susceptible to any increase in amount of hydrogen peroxide inside the cell, and it's erythrocytes. Erythrocytes are the most susceptible cells to oxidative injury. And the reason is that erythrocytes have hemoglobin, and the major structural component of hemoglobin is iron in +2 state. And the function of hemoglobin is to pick up oxygen and deliver oxygen to the tissues. And when hemoglobin picks up oxygen, it binds oxygen to iron. This binding, oxygen oxidizes iron to +3 state, and this results in formation of so-called ferric superoxide anion complex. And usually when erythrocyte comes to the tissue, oxygen simply dissociates from iron. Oxygen diffuses into the tissues, leaving iron in a normal +2 state. But because oxygen is a very unstable molecule, it can spontaneously dissociate. And as human, when someone leaves place in hurry, oxygen does not take back electrons that he had previously donated to iron. Thereby, spontaneous dissociation results in production of superoxide and ferric iron, which is iron in +3 state. So, as a result of spontaneous dissociation, a highly dangerous superoxide molecules are formed, and by the way, hemoglobin that has ferric iron called methemoglobin. Important that this spontaneous dissociation occurs even at normal condition. The routine daily rate of hemoglobin-methemoglobin conversion is roughly 0.5-3% of the total hemoglobin pool per day. So because of the spontaneous generation of superoxide that occurs routinely, erythrocytes are always at risk of oxidative injury. And obviously with constant production of reactive oxygen species, erythrocytes have to provide constant elimination of reactive oxygen species. And as we know, elimination is provided by antioxidant enzymes as glutathione peroxidase. Glutathione peroxidase reduces hydrogen peroxide to water. In this process, two molecules of glutathione gives away two hydrogens. As a result, glutathione disulfide is formed, which is inactive molecule. And to become functionally active again, glutathione disulfate must be reduced to two glutathione molecules. And this conversion is provided by glutathione reductase that use NADPH as coenzyme. NADPH molecules are formed from NADP in oxidative phase of hexose monophosphate shunt. And the crucial enzyme of oxidative phase is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. And because hexose monophosphate shunt is the only mechanism for red blood cells to produce NADPH, with glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, production of NADPH decreases. This causes disruption of glutathione recycling, thereby the activity of glutathione peroxidase decreases, and this basically disrupts detoxification of hydrogen peroxide molecules. As a result, hydrogen peroxide progressively accumulates inside the cell. Moreover, after the intake of fava beans or with infections as pneumonia or viral hepatitis, or after intake of drugs as primaquine, for example, the production of reactive oxygen species increases even further. So in this situation, the level of reactive oxygen species inside the erythrocyte rises to the sky. This condition, known as oxidative stress, and oxidative stress causes severe oxidative injury. Increasing amount of reactive oxygen species causes damage to hemoglobin structure. Basically, hydrogen peroxide causes denaturation of hemoglobin, and the pieces of denaturated hemoglobin inside the erythrocyte, known as Heinz bodies. And when Heinz bodies come in contact with the erythrocyte's membrane, the presence of denaturated hemoglobin causes decrease in flexibility of the membrane. So Heinz bodies increase rigidity of the membrane. And now when erythrocytes in the blood cross the spleen, and recall that the spleen basically provides filtration of blood, these rigid erythrocytes get stuck in the spleen, and trapped erythrocytes then removed from the circulation by the splenic macrophages in a process called splenic sequestration. So decrease in membrane flexibility causes increase in splenic sequestration, and the activity of splenic macrophages results in production of so-called white cells, and obviously the amount of normal red blood cells decrease. And also substantial oxidative stress inside the erythrocyte causes direct damage to erythrocyte's membrane, and at some point damage to the membrane results in intravascular rupture of the erythrocyte, a condition known as hemolytic anemia. With disruption of the membrane, hemoglobin leaks into the circulation, and as we know, hemoglobin is made of heme and globin. Heme is iron in complex with protoporphyrin, and the breakdown of protoporphyrin results in formation of unconjugated bilirubin, and increase in amount of bilirubin causes jaundice. So glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency results in increase in splenic sequestration and in hemolysis of red blood cells. This causes anemia and jaundice. And also glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency disrupts phagocytosis, thereby it causes immune deficiency. Recall that in lysosomes, NADPH molecules are required for activity of NADPH oxidase that induce respiratory burst. And with the respiratory burst, lysosomes produce reactive oxygen species that can kill the bacteria. And the major source of NADPH molecules is hexose monophosphate shunt. And the crucial enzyme in oxidative phase of hexose monophosphate shunt is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. With glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, the production of NADPH decreases. And without NADPH, NADPH oxidase becomes dysfunctional. It cannot generate superoxide, thereby the production of other reactive oxygen species becomes impossible. So entire respiratory burst is disrupted, and without reactive oxygen species, neutrophils cannot kill the bacteria. So patients with glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency have immune deficiency with increased risk of bacterial infections.